Okay, Ben, so what we're going to do, we want to build some strength in your lower chest. Right. Okay, we're doing that by isolating the chest as much as possible, getting your shoulders pinned back, using a bar where your grip is changed so that you can keep that tension focused on the lower chest. Right. We're using the exercise where we can go as heavy as we can, which is compound as possible. So we're doing a decline bench press to hit the lower chest. Okay, and we're going to do about 3 working sets between a 6 to 8 rep range. Very slow, controlled, individual reps, purely to build strength, okay? Later on in the workout, we're then gonna drop the weight, we're gonna go to more isolation movements, and we're gonna pump the muscle to pieces to get the other muscle growth, to pump the muscle up as much as we can, okay? Good. Okay, so in Ben's workout, we've just started to do a little bit of isolation work, take his shoulders out of it, isolate the chest much more. An important point to remember is that we're training here to build muscle, increase muscle size, strength, build a better connection with the muscle. So it's not about training our egos. We're not here to lift absolute maximum weight we can possibly do, because a maximum weight you could possibly do would involve too many other muscle groups. So we're doing the opposite here. We're going as heavy as we can while isolating and really targeting individual muscle groups. This is more bodybuilding than powerlifting. Right, so Ben, what we've done, we've hit our chest hard, heavy, lower, upper, just started to pump the upper, okay? Now what we're gonna do, we're gonna pick an exercise that's gonna kind of really target the middle of the chest, upper and lower together. But this particular exercise is very, very good for connecting, okay? So remember we said we wanna kind of like get a better connection with your chest than you've got with your shoulders at the moment. Yeah. With this exercise, people forget that the chest actually attaches to the outside of the arm, and part of its job is actually to pull the arm across, okay? With this exercise, you're gonna be pushing, like on a press up or a bench press, but all at the same time, you're gonna be pulling in. You're gonna be really targeting the chest and isolating it a lot more. This exercise is gonna be very intense, it's gonna really, really burn, and I want you to work to complete failure. Okay. That means you're gonna go into the pain threshold, into the pain barrier, your body is gonna wanna stop. Okay, and you're going to have to get separated from your body and override your body's need to stop, and then go a few more reps, a few more seconds, till you actually make the muscle completely fail. Okay, so the mind's important in this.
Yeah, it's just the mental block, squeeze, that's it. On the little bit higher, yeah, yes, that's it. Bring elbows together, come up. Squeeze the elbows, go forward, that's it. Forward, that's it. Oh, press. Squeeze, good. Then do 4 more like that. Down, rest, 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 rest. Squeeze, good. Rest, rest, rest. 3, 2, 1, squeeze. Good. Slowly down, slowly down, slowly down. Rest, rest, rest. 1 more. Good. Squeeze, 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 chest, squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Good. Slowly down. Good.
Right, Ben, so we've just done our chest session. Yep. Now, we've established that what you're going to work on is actually isolating upper and lower chest from now on in your chest sessions. Okay. You're going to start off your chest sessions with some basic heavy lifting compound movements. Yep. You're going to focus on pinning your shoulder blades back.
Yeah.
Okay? Really focusing on contorting your body so that you're making the chest do more of the work, dropping the shoulders down and out. Okay, that's going to be a big thing for you to concentrate on.
Yeah.
Today, we pumped up the chest a little bit, but I would have liked to have taken the burn and the pump a lot further. Right. Now, we were pretty drained by the end of the workout. You were lacking in food a little bit drained before we start. So we couldn't go as far as I want to with the pump and burn. Yeah. So next training session, I'm going to give you a taster on the next body part of how far you can actually take the burn and how far you can actually go through the pain barrier. And this is going to be an area of training in which we're going to increase over the next few weeks, because taking your body to extreme pain to extreme burns to extreme pump requires a lot of volume, a lot of energy, produces a lot of growth hormone, a lot of testosterone, and very beneficial for fat burning and very beneficial for muscle volumization. So far, in the 2 weeks since you started, you've made massive improvements. You've thickened up all over, you've lost fat, you've leaned up, and you're improving at a very quick rate with the tweaks we've made. All we're going to do from this point is probably up your carbohydrates slightly before training sessions, so you've got more energy and you're a little bit full. Okay? Have you got any questions?
No, it's good.
Good, yeah, good. Brilliant.
Yeah.
Cool.